The movie starts with Lin Zhenxin, a super hardworking lady who's always at her job. Everyone at work notices her efforts, especially her boss, who praises her in front of everyone. They even have a little party to celebrate her achievements. Just when Zhenxin thinks everything's perfect with her job and love life, things get tricky. She's reminded by her boyfriend about their date, but she can't leave because her boss drops more work on her. Even though her friends at work try to hint to her to say no, she doesn't, and this upsets them. Zhenxin felt really bad about deciding to work extra hours, so she thought she'd cheer up her coworkers by getting some snacks and drinks from the store. But then, she saw her colleagues coming in, and they started complaining about her. It made her feel so hurt that she hid from them. They were saying she works too much, and that it's not worth giving up free time for a little extra money. They felt sorry for her, thinking she's just a dull person who only cares about her job. Zhenxin felt really down after hearing all this, like her hard work didn't matter to them at all. Later that night, Zhenxin looks for some comfort in her box of high school memories. She checks out her diary, which has lots of pictures and stickers of her favorite singer, Andy Lau. Zhenxin remembers how she used to wish she could go to his concerts, but that wish never came true. She starts crying, missing the days when life was easier and more carefree. Now let's go back to Zhenxin's high school days. She wasn't the smartest or the prettiest in class, but she always had a sunny attitude. Her two best buddies were Cha Xiaoqi and Mei Mei, and she often daydreamed about her idol, Andy Lau. Even in class, instead of paying attention, Zhenxin preferred writing love letters to Andy Lau. At school, Zhenxin had a crush on Ouyang Feifan, a popular and good-looking basketball star. Whenever Feifan was around, Zhenxin got all jittery and shy, especially when he thanked her for opening the cafeteria fridge. She never missed any of Feifan's basketball games, and she'd cheer for him the loudest from the sidelines. From a distance, she'd admire his skills and handsome looks. Even though her friends knew about her crush, Zhenxin treasured those carefree high school days. Zhenxin couldn't help but be jealous of her classmate and neighbor Tao Minmin. Minmin was not only pretty but also really popular and smart. One day, while watching Minmin get frustrated sifting through a bunch of love letters, Zhenxin just stared in amazement. It seemed like Minmin got love letters from guys almost every day, which made Zhenxin even more envious. But then, something interesting happened. Minmin's best friend, Shen Qiedi, decided to show all those letters to the whole class. She warned everyone that if they dared to put love letters in Minmin's desk, they'd be in trouble. In that pile of letters, there was one that was really weird. It was written in English, but the grammar was all wrong. Even though Zhenxin had been jealous of Minmin, she had never really listened to her complain about all those love letters before. Zhenxin got a shock when she found an envelope in her desk drawer with her name, Lin Truly, on it. At first, she was all excited, but then she got really scared when she read the letter. It said she had to send copies of the letter to 5 people within 3 days, or something bad would happen. Zhenxin was so scared that she banged on her table, and the whole class looked at her. At home, Zhenxin's parents always praised her older brother. He looked like a punk, but he was super smart and got great grades. Zhenxin tried to defend herself, but her parents just ignored her and gave her brother lots of good food, while she only got plain rice and simple stuff. Zhenxin was mad, and she thought about sending the cursed letter to her brother. But then she realized that if her brother got in trouble, she would too. After thinking about it a lot, she decided to send the first letter to her math and homeroom teacher, Teacher Wang. Teacher Wang was famous for being really strict and giving tough punishments for bad grades. Zhenxin got in trouble when she got a bad grade, and Teacher Wang was about to hit her hand with a wooden ruler. But Zhenxin was quick and moved out of the way. She slyly put the curse letter into one of Mr. Wang's books. During break time, Zhenxin really wanted to see her crush, Feifan. She hid behind a tree, hoping to hear him talk and get closer to him. To her joy, Feifan started playing the guitar and singing. Even waved at Zhenxin as she watched from a distance. But her happiness didn't last long because suddenly Minmin showed up and stood next to Feifan. Zhenxin felt so embarrassed, so she went back into hiding, watching as her crush smiled and whispered with Minmin. It made her heart ache, and she decided to leave. While walking past Minmin's quiet house, Zhenxin got an idea to send her a cursed letter. She quietly put it in her mailbox, realizing she had 3 more to deliver. But things got tricky, and she wasn't sure what to do until she saw Feifan being bullied by Tsu Taiyu. Taiyu was a troublemaker, and no school wanted him. Strangely, he became a school patrol officer to watch over the unruly students. That's when Zhenxin saw her chance to give him the cursed letter. While Taiyu and his friends were playing at the pool, She slipped the letter into his bag and left quickly, glad her plan worked out. Later that day, Tai Yu and his buddies were walking together when he found the pink, scented letter in his bag. He thought it was a love letter and got super excited, so he sent his teasing friends away. As he read the letter, he didn't notice a car coming, and he got hit and went flying onto the road. Sen Shin was really shocked when she heard about Tai Yu's accident. She never expected things to turn out so bad. Meanwhile, Tai Yu was super mad and determined to find out who sent him that cursed letter. He told his friends to search every classroom for any proof or clues. Sakuraji found Sen Shin's desk covered in Andy Law stickers, just like the one on the cursed letter. There were also two similar letters in her drawer. When Sen Shin came home from school, Sakuragi and Daho confronted her and brought her to see Tai Yu. Sen Shin was really scared when she saw Tai Yu. He looked pretty intimidating with his weird hairstyle, round eyes, and sneaky smile. Tai Yu acted like he wanted to be friends, but it was just a trick. He actually wanted to force her to be his servant, and his friends were totally ready to help him with it. Tai Yu wasted no time making Sen Shin do all sorts of work for him. She had to do the homework and assignments for the class that did the worst in school, which happened to be Tai Yu's class. On top of that, Sen Shin had to pay for their lunches too. She agreed to all this because Tai Yu had threatened to hurt Fei Fan, the guy she liked. Tai Yu knew about Sen Shin's feelings for Fei Fan because his friend found a picture of him in her desk. So Sen Shin had to do Tai Yu's homework and bring him food every day. One day, Sen Shin hurried to Tai Yu's classroom to give him his homework. But as she was about to leave, Tai Yu stopped her and promised to reward her hard work with a signed photo of the famous actor Andy Lau. Sen Shin was so happy and smiled as she gladly accepted. But her happiness didn't last long. Tai Yu and his friends started laughing, and it turned out it was all just a joke. Feeling let down and embarrassed, Sen Shin ran away from there. On another day, Tai Yu tried to convince Sen Shin to skip school and go to the mall with him. Sen Shin was scared of climbing the school wall, but she said no, not wanting to break the rules. But Tai Yu kept insisting and even helped Sen Shin get over her fear to climb the wall. When they got to the mall, Tai Yu and his friends started roller skating, leaving Sen Shin out of the fun. She had a hard time keeping her balance and almost fell. When Tang Yu noticed she was upset, he told her to follow him. Sen Shin was frustrated and wanted to say no, but she felt like she couldn't resist Tai Yu's orders. Sen Shin screamed in terror as she lost her grip and fell during their game at the amusement park. Tai Yu found it funny and pretended to care, but then went back to playing when he saw Sen Shin was okay. As Sen Shin limped off to buy Tai Yu some squid meatballs, she grumbled to herself and cursed the hard floor that hurt her. Suddenly, a group of people with batons showed up and everyone, including the food vendor, ran to hide. Sen Shin was confused at first, but then she got scared as the bullies went after Tai Yu and his friends. One of them knocked Tai Yu down, and Sen Shin watched in horror as they kept beating him. In a brave moment, Sen Shin grabbed Tai Yu's fallen stick and threw it at him. Things changed quickly, and Tai Yu and his pals fought back, giving the bullies a beating. But Sen Shin was too scared to join in, so she hid while the fight went on. When the bullies finally left, they saw Sen Shin's face in uniform, and she screamed in fear while trying to cover herself. The school staff noticed what happened, and Sen Shin ended up in the principal's office. She was really scared and wanted to tell the truth, but Sakuragi signaled her not to say anything. Daho showed her a photo of Fei Fan and Tai Yu and squeezed it, which was a clear warning that they would hurt Fei Fan if Sen Shin spilled the beans. Sen Shin was really scared and couldn't bring herself to tell the truth to the principal, who got angry and punished her by making her clean the swimming pool. She wanted to argue, but her bravery vanished, and she left the room feeling like she lost. While she walked around the school, she saw Fei Fan coming her way, and it made her panic. She desperately tried to find a hiding spot. She acted all cool and pretended to read the school announcements when Fei Fan walked by. But her two best friends got all excited and got his attention. Fei Fan called out to her, and she made a silly face to avoid talking to him. But he gave her a compliment and said he liked roller skating too. He even asked if they could skate together sometime. Sen Shin was over the moon and couldn't hide her happiness, especially when her friends encouraged her, saying that now Fei Fan knew her name and might ask her out. Sen Shin managed to find a silver lining in her tough situation of being Tai Yu's servant. She and her friends laughed and danced while doing their punishment. Her heart was so happy after getting compliments from Fei Fan. As she sang to herself while cleaning the pool, Sen Shin heard some voices nearby and went to check it out. She was really surprised to find Fei-Fan and Min-Min having a serious talk. She listened in and felt sad when she heard Fei-Fan comforting a crying Min-Min and offering to be the father of her future child. After a while, Fei-Fan ended the talk and asked Min-Min to go, but he got surprised when he saw a pool net nearby, even though nobody was around earlier. Min-Min was scared, but Fei-Fan tried to calm her down and told her to leave. Zhen-Shen was still in shock after overhearing Fei-Fan and Min-Min's conversation. She cried and pretended to sink to the bottom of the pool on purpose. Tai-Yu jumped in and saved her, but he was all emotional and crying when they came up. Embarrassed, Tai-Yu acted like he was scolding Zhen-Shen and thought she tried to end her life because of the punishment. Later, they dried it off and sat on the school roof, where Zhen-Shen found Tai-Yu's love letter to Min-Min. It wasn't very creative and just quoted song lyrics. Zhen-Shen teased him, and Tai-Yu got annoyed and crushed his drink can. Trying to cheer him up, Zhen-Shen shared her secret love story, and Tai-Yu suggested that they team up to break up Fei-Fan and Min-Min so they could pursue their crushes. They started investigating and followed Fei-Fan and Min-Min, who were about to meet somewhere. As it turned out, Min-Min and Fei-Fan's meeting wasn't a romantic date, but just to look after a cute little black dog they considered their baby. Tai-Yu felt relieved they weren't dating, but he had other plans. He was determined to keep Min-Min away from Fei-Fan and came up with a sneaky plan. One day after school, Tai-Yu's friends blocked Min-Min's way, hoping Tai-Yu would tell her he liked her. But Min-Min wasn't interested in Tai-Yu because he had a reputation for causing trouble. She sarcastically smiled and even bumped into him with her bike, which only made him more annoyed. After Tai-Yu's friends left, Zhen-Shen came out of her hiding spot and suggested they should give up because it was clear Min-Min wasn't interested in Tai-Yu. But Tai-Yu didn't want to give up. He came up with a new plan to take the puppy so that Min-Min wouldn't have a reason to meet Fei-Fan secretly. Even though Zhen-Shen had doubts, she agreed to help Tai-Yu with his scheme. Zhen-Shen had a crafty idea to make it look like the dog was lost, not kidnapped. She used milk to make fake paw prints and hoped Min-Min and Fei-Fan wouldn't figure it out. Tai-Yu, though, got all nervous and told Zhen-Shen to leave before they got caught. So they took the puppy up to the roof of the building. When they got up to the roof, Zhen-Shen was surprised to see Tai-Yu petting the dog gently. She never thought he liked animals. Tai-Yu then decided that Zhen-Shen should look after the puppy, at least until they found her a new home. But as Tai-Yu handed over the dog, it suddenly peed, which surprised them both. However, they started laughing, and Tai-Yu wasn't mad at the dog. As they settled down, Zhen-Shen asked Tai-Yu about the dog's name. He suggested calling her Andy, after his favorite idol. But Zhen-Shen didn't like using a boy's name for a girl dog. Tai-Yu then said they could use the initials ND, but Zhen-Shen still didn't like it, and they ended up arguing, which turned into a playful chase around the roof. In class, Min-Min was feeling sad and worried because her dog was missing. Meanwhile, Zhen-Shen tried to hide her guilt behind a book. Suddenly, their teacher, Teacher Wong, came into the classroom and said he got a cursed letter from a student. He showed it to the class and scolded the person who wrote it for being foolish. Zhen-Shen felt guilty and wanted to confess, but she didn't have the courage. After class, she went to the teacher's office to admit what she did. But to her surprise, Tai-Yu and Min-Min were already there. The teacher was scolding Tai-Yu, but he seemed more interested in flirting with Zhen-Shen than worrying about his punishment. Before Zhen-Shen could speak up, Tai-Yu took the blame for the curse letter. The teacher was relieved and let Zhen-Shen go, leaving her and Min-Min shocked but quiet. In another room, Tai-Yu's homeroom teacher and another teacher scolded him at the same time, which annoyed him. He asked them to talk one by one, and Zhen-Shen watched him curiously while pretending to leave. She heard the teachers talking about Tai-Yu's past achievements and how he used to be a troublemaker. After school, Zhen-Shen thanked Tai-Yu for helping her and confessed that she was the one who sent the third curse letter to Min-Min. Tai-Yu was mad at first but forgave her when she said sorry. Then, Zhen-Shen showed him a book of poems and suggested he try writing poetry to avoid getting caught cheating. She also thought that maybe Min-Min might like Tai-Yu, since girls are hard to understand. Tai-Yu smiled at her idea, but he didn't know if Zhen-Shen's advice would work. The next day, Zhen-Shen was at Fei-Fan's basketball game while looking through her junior high yearbook. While going through the book, she came across a picture of Fei-Fan and noticed that he used to be in the same class as Tai-Yu. She got curious and decided to ask Fei-Fan about their past. Her two friends who were reading a magazine together were surprised by Zhen-Shen's bold move. But Zhen-Shen didn't give up and asked Fei-Fan if he knew Tai-Yu. At first, Fei Fan was hesitant to talk about it, but eventually he opened up. He told Zhen Xin that he and Tai Yu used to be best friends in middle school. Fei Fan then talked about a sad incident when he, Tai Yu, and another friend named Ma Su Yuan went to the beach after school. Su Yuan came up with a challenge to see who could swim the farthest in the sea within 3 minutes. Tai Yu accepted the challenge, but unfortunately, Su Yuan drowned during the competition. Fei Fan didn't let Tai Yu try to save Su Yuan because he thought it was too dangerous. Since that day, Tai Yu blamed Fei Fan for his friend's death and had a deep grudge against him. As Zhen Xin clutched the yearbook tightly, she finally understood why Tai Yu had been so upset at the pond and why he had helped her. It was because Tai Yu was deeply affected by Su Yuan's death, and that's why he had such strong feelings against Fei Fan. Zhen Xin felt determined to help Tai Yu heal from his pain and guilt. Zhen Xin grabbed a red piece of chalk and drew a line on the schoolyard. She patiently waited for Tai Yu to arrive. When he showed up, Zhen Xin surprised him by appearing on roller skates and challenging him to a race. She said the winner could make a wish. However, Zhen Xin fell down quickly, and it made Tai Yu laugh. Even though Tai Yu teased and insulted her, Zhen Xin didn't give up. Eventually, she managed to cross the red line and win the race. Tai Yu was puzzled about the race, but Zhen Xin shared that Fei Fan had confided in her about the Su Yuan incident. She explained that Tai Yu helped her at the pond because he was still troubled by Su Yuan's death. Zhen Xin encouraged Tai Yu to make amends with Fei Fan, thinking that Su Yuan wouldn't want them to be enemies. This made Tai Yu really angry, and he grabbed Zhen Xin's hands, threatening to hit her. Zhen Xin stayed quiet as Tai Yu let go of her hands and stormed off. But Zhen Xin didn't give up. She went after Tai Yu, even though she fell down again. Tai Yu stopped and turned back to help her. Zhen Xin said she wanted to race again, and Tai Yu agreed. Then he realized the accident had been his fault and stayed silent while helping Zhen Xin up. She reminded him that the winner could make a wish, so Tai Yu asked what she wanted. Zhen Xin just wanted to see the old Tai Yu. This made Tai Yu remember a time when he only cried after seeing Su Yuan drinking and throwing away half of his drink. Su Yuan smiled at him, and Tai Yu felt calm as he walked home. The classroom was its usual chaotic self, with students playing around and not paying attention to the lesson. But Tai Yu was different. He sat quietly and was well-dressed, waiting for the teacher to come in. When the slim male teacher walked in, he didn't seem bothered by the noisy class and had experience teaching in tough situations. A student with glasses at the front stood up to greet him, and Tai Yu did the same. The other students reluctantly greeted the teacher but quickly went back to their usual behavior. Tai Yu got frustrated and banged his hand on the desk, making his friends jump back to their seats. The teacher asked nervously if Tai Yu had any questions, which surprised both his classmates and the teacher. Tai Yu asked about the last lesson, which caused a commotion in the classroom. The teacher said they were going to talk about Chapter 7, page 125, about the Second World War. Tai Yu tried to find the page but got corrected by the teacher, who pointed out that he had the wrong book. Tai Yu had been causing trouble in class, insisting that his friends open a book they didn't have. The only person with the book was the student with glasses, sitting in the front of the classroom. Reluctantly, Tai Yu and his friends joined the students' group. On Sunday, Zhen Xin was getting ready to meet Tai Yu at a restaurant to study together. She felt confident with her makeup, but when she saw Tai Yu, he teased her for looking like a grown-up going to a temple festival. Annoyed, Zhen Xin walked away, leaving Tai Yu behind, still making fun of her. Tai Yu chased after her and took her bag, carrying both bags like Zhen Xin used to do. Zhen Xin was thrilled to walk with Tai Yu, especially when she overheard some girls admiring Tai Yu's good looks. She was so happy that she didn't notice a fast-approaching car coming around the corner behind her. The car honked, startling Zhen Xin, and Tai Yu quickly hugged her to protect her from the oncoming vehicle. The atmosphere grew quiet as Tai Yu reluctantly let go of Zhen Xin and gestured for her to step aside while he walked beside the highway. To Zhen Xin's surprise, the once impolite and grumpy Tai Yu had transformed into someone gentle and romantic. When they reached the restaurant, Tai Yu found a table while Zhen Xin went to order food. While waiting in line, Zhen Xin was taken aback when Min Min and Chia Yi suddenly appeared and saw Tai Yu studying alone. After some hesitation, Min Min approached Tai Yu, encouraged him to study hard, and offered her assistance. Zhen Xin returned with the food, only to discover that Min Min had promised to provide her bio data to Tai Yu, which made him blush. As Min Min left, Tai Yu seemed confused about why she had accused him of misspelling Destiny as Disney in his previous letter when Disney was his pen name. When Zenshin asked about their conversation, Taiyu simply said they had talked. After Taiyu's encounter with Min Min, he became a committed student, inspiring his classmates to change their classroom environment and behavior for the better. However, Zenshin was unsure if Taiyu had changed because of his promise to her or because of Min Min's encouragement. Whenever Taiyu smiled at Min Min as they passed by each other, Zenshin couldn't help but feel a pang of sadness, knowing that Taiyu had feelings for her. One day, while buying the latest textbook at the bookstore, Zenshin spotted an Andy Law poster and couldn't contain her excitement. She hugged the poster and screamed, expressing her dream of attending his concert in Taipei. Taiyu smiled and promised to ask Andy Law to sing for her someday. Their joyful moment was interrupted when the shop owner got upset with Zenshin for touching the poster, leading Taiyu to grab her hand and run away. When Taiyu and Zenshin got together to study, Taiyu surprised Zenshin with his excellent math skills, which he had developed from participating in science Olympiads. He saw this as a chance to help Zenshin, who had always struggled with math. Their enthusiasm for learning impressed their friend who was with them. Later, as Taiyu walked Zenshin home, he declined to accompany her all the way to her doorstep because he wanted to see Min Min. This led to a playful exchange between them, during which Taiyu showed Zenshin a keychain featuring an Andy Law doll that he had intended to give to Min Min. Zenshin caught the keychain and was delighted. As they strolled along, Zenshin asked Taiyu about what men found attractive in a girl. Taiyu teased her by mentioning that Fei Fan admired Vivian Chow, but that he himself preferred cute girls like Yuki Uchida and Noriko Sakai. Zenshin playfully complained that Taiyu only liked Japanese actresses, to which he simply smiled. Then, out of the blue, she asked Taiyu to teach her how to rollerblade since Fei Fan was skilled at it. Taiyu agreed to be her teacher. The next day after school, Zenshin bought a magazine with a Japanese cover artist on the front and hoped to copy Taiyu's idol's style. As she approached her home, she noticed a fashionable girl with trendy makeup waiting outside. It turned out the girl was waiting for her older brother named San San. Zenshin was intrigued by the girl's stylish hairstyle, which looked like the one worn by the Japanese cover artist in her magazine. She asked the girl how she could dress up like her. Suddenly, San San, Zenshin's brother, appeared and scolded her. But to Zenshin's surprise, the girl stood up for her and offered to help. Zenshin couldn't help but smile happily, ignoring San San's angry expression. The next day, Min Min got worried when she found out about Fei Fan's ankle injury. But things got tense when Chia Yi arrived and hinted that Zenshin's friends weren't real friends of Fei Fan. Chia Yi greeted Fei Fan enthusiastically, which annoyed Mei Mei, but Xiao Qi calmed her down. They were surprised that Zenshin wasn't there, but they saw it as a chance to get Fei Fan's attention. Fei Fan's eyes wandered, and he noticed Zenshin, who looked different that morning. Usually, her hair was messy. Her bangs were pinned up, and she wore glasses. But this time, her hair was neatly combed, and she had bangs without her glasses. As Zenshin walked into the cafeteria, she couldn't help but smile when she saw Fei Fan. Taiyu, who was eating noodles nearby, also noticed how different Zenshin seemed all of a sudden. She confidently made her way to the ice cream counter, but when she held a cone, she felt a bit unsure about giving it to Fei Fan. In a surprising twist, Taiyu gently pushed her toward Fei Fan and signaled her to offer him the ice cream. Meanwhile, Min Min, who felt a bit ignored by Fei Fan, decided to head straight to class. Fei Fan, however, complimented Zenshin on her newfound confidence and wished her good luck on her upcoming exams. Zenshin's two friends were overjoyed and showered her with congratulations for her recent change. But Zenshin didn't look as excited as they did. Instead, she glanced over at Taiyu, who was pretending to be absorbed in his bowl of noodles. A few days later, they posted the exam results, and it was a big surprise that Taiyu ranked 10th. But their joy didn't last long as a strict and tough new principal took over. This new principal showed no mercy to the students of class 317, including Taiyu's classmates. He even replaced the school patrol officer. The class that used to be lively and energetic was now seen as a lower class, and the students had to deal with the new principal's strict rules. Despite all the belittling from the new principal, Taiyu didn't back down. He was fearless and even defiant, holding out his hand as a sign of resistance when leaving the principal's office. However, things got worse when the headmaster accused Taiyu of cheating on his exam and said he didn't deserve his 10th place ranking. The headmaster asked if anyone had helped Taiyu cheat, but all the students stayed silent. So the headmaster decided to punish the whole class, but Taiyu didn't want his classmates to suffer for something they didn't do. In the end, Taiyu was the only one who got punished and had to run around the field 50 times. While the other students watched Taiyu being punished, they were worried but too scared to step in. Meanwhile, Chia Yi started spreading rumors that Taiyu had cheated on the exam. But Zhen Xin strongly defended him, knowing he had worked hard to earn his ranking. Even though Zhen Xin tried to talk to the headmaster and convince him otherwise, he wouldn't budge and even threatened to make Taiyu's punishment worse. After the exhausting run, Taiyu collapsed. From then on, Zhen Xin couldn't stop worrying about Taiyu because he seemed to have vanished. Zhen Xin sat at her desk, lost in thought as she gazed at Taiyu's doodles. Her friends complained about Principal Chuan's strict rules, but Zhen Xin stayed quiet, lost in her own thoughts. Then, a thought hit her. They should boycott Principal Chuan's rules. With her four friends' assistance, Zhen Xin made flyers and tried to give them to other students. But most students were too scared of the principal to accept or read the flyers. Zhen Xin was determined to spread the word about an upcoming event, but Chia Yi stopped her from giving flyers to Min Min. Despite feeling discouraged, Zhen Xin got her motivation back when Fei Fan offered to help distribute the flyers with his friends. Unfortunately, their efforts were discovered by Teacher Wang, who punished Zhen Xin with a two-day detention. At home, Zhen Xin's parents scolded her for her actions and even grounded her to her room. But soon, their anger turned towards each other after a call from Teacher Wang. While Zhen Xin's parents argued, the phone rang, and her mother answered to a prank caller who hung up quickly. Thinking it might be Taiyu, Zhen Xin rushed to her room, hoping for his call. When the phone rang, it was indeed Taiyu on the line, expressing concern for her after his hospitalization. Even though she wanted to talk, Zhen Xin abruptly ended the conversation, asking him not to call for 2 days. Taiyu was puzzled by her sudden detachment, especially since her mother's earlier angry response raised suspicions. Zhen Xin was in the middle of writing when she heard pebbles hitting her window. She went out onto the balcony and saw Taiyu outside her house. Despite trying to act casual, their emotions were evident. Taiyu claimed he was passing by, but Zhen Xin couldn't help but look at him with longing, silently hoping he would open up about his recent troubles. As Taiyu was about to leave, Zhen Xin suddenly asked him to wait. He waited nervously, not knowing what she had in mind. When she returned, she was holding their beloved dog, a gesture that deeply touched Taiyu. During Taiyu's punishment run, he stumbled and Zhen Xin rushed over to check on him. After confirming that he was just dehydrated and exhausted, Taiyu admitted that he was surprisingly happy to be suspended, which surprised Zhen Xin. While they talked, Taiyu noticed Zhen Xin's eyes fixated on the bandage on his arm, so he quickly removed it to ease her worry. Jokingly, Zhen Xin mentioned that anyone connected to Taiyu seemed to get into trouble, and Taiyu shared that he had come to find her because he remembered her advice about girls being indirect. With Indeed, the dog they had rescued together by their side, Taiyu led Zhen Xin to a playground adorned with colorful lights. Taiyu surprised her with a pair of roller skates and offered to teach her how to use them. As they practiced together, Taiyu showed great patience, helping Zhen Xin up every time she stumbled and holding her hand to keep her steady. They shared laughter and enjoyed each other's company, all while Indeed watched from the sidelines. During the school festival, a hall buzzed with excitement as students and their families gathered. Principal Chuan announced the names of the students who had secured the top 10 spots. Cheers and applause erupted as Fei Fan proudly claimed the first position, and Min Min smiled with satisfaction at her fifth place ranking. Zhen Xin glanced at Taiyu, who returned her look with an encouraging smile, knowing he was up next to be called as the 10th place student. However, there was a sudden shock when the principal skipped over Taiyu's name, claiming that he had cheated and didn't deserve his place. Taiyu was in disbelief and stood up, but the accusation was too much for him, and he fainted from the shock. While Taiyu's friends were furious and voiced their anger, the principal continued to belittle him, calling him a worthless student. Zhen Xin tried to comfort Taiyu, but he sat there silently, feeling defeated and hurt as the principal disregarded his reputation and dignity. Unable to bear the injustice, Zhen Xin mustered her courage and walked toward the stage, determined to defend Taiyu's honor. She even bent a few rules to get the principal's attention, but he remained unmoved and unwilling to listen. Zhen Xin persisted, questioning the fairness of rules that could be so easily ignored. Just when it seemed like there was no hope, Fei Fan unexpectedly appeared on stage and admitted that he had cheated on the exam, insisting on being punished for his actions. Zhen Xin was overwhelmed with joy and touched by Fei Fan's unexpected support. Feifan's father was in disbelief when he heard the accusation against his son. Feifan defended himself by suggesting that if the principal could accuse Tai Yu of cheating, he could do the same. The headmaster was furious and threatened to punish Feifan, but the students rallied to support him. Mei Mei even went so far as to strip down to her shorts, showing her willingness to face punishment for breaking the rules. This bold move inspired other students to admit their own wrongdoings, including Min Min, who confessed to bringing a communication device to school. The homeroom teachers were delighted to see the students standing up for each other and cheered on Zhen Xin, who had encouraged them to be model students. Zhen Xin argued that a person's character shouldn't be defined solely by grades and rules, emphasizing that everyone makes mistakes. Feifan stood by her side, impressed by her courage. Principal Chuan was furious and wanted to punish Zhen Xin for her rebellious actions, but the former principal stepped in and promised to work with him to improve the school. This pledge united the students and diffused the tension in the end. It was the school's birthday, and the students were excited about the water balloon war. Zhen Xin and Tai Yu teamed up, having a great time tossing balloons at each other. Feifan joined in, becoming Zhen Xin's protector, while Min Min stuck close to Tai Yu. They all had a blast, sharing laughter and playfulness. During the school vacation, they went camping on motorcycles. Zhen Xin paired up with Fei Dan, and Min Min was with Tai Yu. When they reached the campsite, they enjoyed dancing and having a good time together. Later that evening, Tai Yu went to collect firewood and opened up to Zhen Xin, admitting that he found her personality more appealing than Min Min's. He even playfully said that she was just as beautiful as Min Min. Zhen Xin blushed but quickly joined in the fun, trying to kick Tai Yu. They shared laughter as Tai Yu approached to help her carry the firewood. As they sat beneath the shimmering stars, Zhen Xin asked Tai Yu for a promise in case they went to different colleges. She wanted him to promise to study hard, avoid fights, and not hurt those who cared for him. Tai Yu agreed solemnly and then had a request in return. Zhen Xin was surprised when Tai Yu leaned in close, but he had a lighthearted ask, that she never mix sesame oil with noodles. At first, Zhen Xin pretended to be annoyed, but she eventually smiled because she knew she often messed up the noodle orders. When a shooting star streaked across the night sky, Zhen Xin encouraged Tai Yu to make a wish. He was hesitant at first but raised his hand and joined in, silently sending his hope to the stars. Little did they know, Feifan was secretly watching them from behind a tree. As soon as the school exams ended, Mei Mei got word from Sakuragi that Tai Yu had been missing for more than a week and had even skipped the exams. This news troubled Zhen Xin, and she tried to call Tai Yu that night, but he didn't pick up. The next day, in a hurry to go somewhere, Zhen Xin spotted Tai Yu sneaking into the principal's office. She felt an urgent need to talk to him, so she nervously waited, her heart racing. When Tai Yu noticed Zhen Xin, he tried to avoid her, walking away without acknowledging her. Despite her repeated attempts to reach him, Zhen Xin blocked his path. Worried about why he missed the exams, she asked Tai Yu for an explanation, but he curtly replied that it was none of her business. As Tai Yu remained uncooperative and lazy, unwilling to explain, Zhen Xin's frustration grew. She couldn't contain her anger any longer and confronted him about his tendency to get into fights. Tai Yu, however, responded with a cold stare, unmoved by her tears. This infuriated Zhen Xin, and she declared that she would cut ties with him. She walked away, wiping her tears. From then on, they avoided each other, their once close friendship irreparably damaged as they silently passed by each other in the school hallways. On her birthday, when Zhen Xin returned home, she was surprised to find an andilaw stand in front of her house. She initially thought it might be from Tai Yu, but it turned out to be Daha and Sakuragi, who had set it up to wish her a happy birthday. Although they didn't know where Tai Yu was, he had remembered her special day and sent her a gift. Daha explained that Zhen Xin could only open and listen to the contents of the cassette when she passed her university exam. Overjoyed, Zhen Xin blushed and hugged Andy Law's stand, convinced that the gift must contain something special. The following day, Zhen Xin and her closest friends were all set to celebrate her birthday during recess when Tai Yu walked past her classroom. Excited, Zhen Xin thought that Tai Yu might be searching for her, so she hurriedly dashed out to meet him. As they strolled towards the rooftop of the school building, they chatted about Tai Yu's gift for her. However, when Zhen Xin handed him her diary to write his bio, Min Min suddenly appeared, holding an umbrella. Tai Yu greeted Min Min with a smile and took her hand, leaving Zhen Xin feeling lonely and disheartened. As Tai Yu got closer to Zhen Xin, she asked him if he had been looking for her. Taiyu then disclosed that Min Min had confessed her feelings for him. Shocked, Zenshin struggled to hide her tears and congratulated Taiyu, although her heart was clearly broken. Taiyu didn't seem overly thrilled about offering his congratulations either. In an attempt to cheer her up, Taiyu suggested that she could spend time with Fei Fan. Suddenly, rain started pouring down, and Min Min opened her umbrella and walked over to Taiyu. Zenshin declined their company and hurried away with her book. Taiyu called out to her, but Zenshin refused to return and kept her distance. While running, she slipped and fell, prompting Taiyu to rush to her aid. However, she signaled for him to stay back, because she didn't want him to see her crying. After she managed to get away, her tears couldn't be held back any longer. The rest of the day passed in a blur for Zenshin, who remained deeply saddened and heartbroken. She spent some time gazing at the keychain Taiyu had given her, lost in her thoughts. When Mei Mei came by with gossip about Andy Law having a girlfriend, Zenshin didn't react at all, too absorbed in her own sorrow. Everyone dismissed Mei Mei's claims as mere rumors. Several days later, as Zenshin entered the classroom, she overheard Xie Yi consoling a tearful Min Min. It appeared that Min Min felt like Taiyu had deceived her, because he had suddenly left the country after she confessed her feelings for him. Xie Yi advised Min Min to steer clear of that peculiar guy. Zenshin was devastated by the news of Taiyu's departure and couldn't seem to locate him anywhere. Meanwhile, Mei Mei indulged in some gossip with their friends about Taiyu's expulsion from school and his subsequent departure. However, everyone fell silent when Zenshin walked into the room. Despite her efforts to carry on with her daily routine, Zenshin couldn't shake the feeling of Taiyu's absence in her life. There were moments when she felt like he was there to protect her, like when she narrowly avoided being hit by a car, but it turned out to be Fei Fan who came to her rescue. Although Fei Fan seemed interested in spending time with her, Zenshin was still grieving over Taiyu. She often went roller skating with ND to distract herself from her sorrow. However, she soon realized that Taiyu had inspired her to work harder in her studies and improve herself, a fact she deeply appreciated. While rummaging through her desk drawer, Zenshin came across a letter adorned with an Andy Law sticker, reminiscent of the curse letter she had once created. Intrigued, she carefully unfolded the note and noticed that it was intricately folded in a unique way. Inside, she found a simple yet heartfelt request. Would the lovely Zenshin be willing to be his friend? After a challenging period of studying, Zenshin finally achieved success by passing her university exams. To celebrate her triumph, Fei Fan, her friend and study companion, suggested they take a leisurely walk. During their stroll, Zenshin expressed her gratitude to Fei Fan for his invaluable help, especially in math, a subject she had struggled with. Being the considerate friend he was, Fei Fan also reminded Zenshin not to forget about the recording Taiyu had entrusted to him, a promise he had made to Taiyu. During a camping trip, Fei Fan shared that he had witnessed Zenshin and Taiyu spending time together. He had also talked to Taiyu about Zenshin, discovering that their connection had started with the curse letter. Initially, Taiyu disliked Zenshin, but upon reading the letter, he realized she was a kind-hearted girl. In her letter, Zenshin had apologized and expressed her belief that Taiyu could change his life for the better. Instead of getting angry, Taiyu found her intriguing and wanted to get to know her better, so he chose to befriend her to stay close. Over time, Taiyu's feelings for Zenshin deepened. He had rescued her from drowning in the pool without hesitation, and when they first studied together, he was incredibly nervous, eagerly awaiting her arrival. It was during those moments that Taiyu recognized he had developed romantic feelings for her. He even felt grateful for the near car accident, as it had allowed him to hold her close and feel her racing heart in his arms. When Min Min joined Taiyu, he decided to stay quiet to avoid any misunderstandings with Zenshin. However, their silence created an awkward atmosphere between them. Taiyu eventually confessed that his previous mistreatment of Zenshin had been a way to get closer to her. He enjoyed being around her and remembered everything she said, including her likes and dislikes. That's why he had given Zenshin Andy Law's keychain at the store, but was too embarrassed to admit it was from him. Later, when Zenshin told him that nothing was wrong over the phone, Taiyu rushed to her house, even though he was feeling weak. He realized he had feelings for Zenshin, but lacked the courage to confess, because he knew she liked Fei Fan. Taiyu hoped to be included in Zenshin's prayers during a shooting star. He even shared Zenshin's habits and preferences with Fei Fan to get closer to her. Taiyu also knew that Zenshin wanted to study at Taiwan University but struggled with math, so he made math study notes for her, leaving them with Fei Fan to make it seem like he had helped her. Fei Fan shared the story of his last encounter with Tai Yu during their camping trip, and it left Zhen Xin in tears. Tai Yu had gone overseas for surgery to treat injuries he had sustained from various incidents, getting hit by a car, a head injury from roller skating, and running 50 laps that caused blood clots in his head. Tai Yu had kept his condition a secret from Zhen Xin because he didn't want to worry her. When Zhen Xin saw Tai Yu fighting recently, it was all to protect her. Tai Yu was saddened by Zhen Xin's misunderstanding, but he wanted her not to worry about him. Zhen Xin felt devastated after hearing Fei Fan's account of the whole story. She regretted not knowing sooner, but it was too late to change anything now. That evening, Zhen Xin sat on the bench where she used to practice roller skating with Tai Yu. She listened to Tai Yu's recorded voice through her earphones and felt a whirlwind of emotions. Tai Yu believed that Zhen Xin was happy with Fei Fan while he was with Min Min. They had kept their promise to help each other get closer to their crushes. When Zhen Xin turned around, she saw Tai Yu sitting beside her. He gave her a smile and confessed that even though she was short, sometimes silly, and like other people, he still liked her. Tai Yu opened his heart to Zhen Xin, and tears welled up in her eyes. He encouraged her to look out at the sky because he would also be gazing at the same starry expanse. Tai Yu concluded the recording by declaring his love for Zhen Xin. The story then brings us to a moment in Zhen Xin's life where she has grown and become more mature. On a particular night, she revisits a familiar place while listening to a voice message left by Tai Yu, the person she has feelings for. As she looks at her diary, she finds Tai Yu's name written inside and feels a newfound determination. The following day, she enters her boss's office with a fresh sense of confidence in hands in her resignation letter. This surprises her colleagues because they are accustomed to her always following her boss's orders. They admire her courage, and Zhen Xin feels a sense of pride in herself. However, her journey is not without challenges. When Zhen Xin returns home, her boyfriend is upset about her decision to leave her job, fearing financial difficulties. Despite his objections, Zhen Xin stands up for herself and decides to end their relationship. Zhen Xin is a big fan of Andy Law, and when she finally sees him in person, she feels a mix of bravery and foolishness. She can't believe how popular he still is after such a long career. Although she admires him, she's frustrated that she has never been able to get a ticket to see him perform live. As she strolls around the concert area, Zhen Xin can only watch with longing as others who were lucky enough to have tickets enjoy the show. She settles for taking a picture with Andy Law's poster and listening to his songs on her phone. While lost in her thoughts, a man enters the shop and a keychain drops in front of him. He picks it up and realizes it belongs to Zhen Xin. He walks over to her and shows her the keychain. When she turns around, she's shocked to see Andy Law standing right in front of her. Andy gestures for Zhen Xin to stay calm and not make a scene, as he's enjoying a break from being in the spotlight. Zhen Xin tries to pretend that she's not a fan, but her cover is blown when she accidentally unplugs her earphones, and Andy's singing voice starts playing. She tries to play it off by saying a friend downloaded the song, not realizing it was his. Zhen Xin even attempts to show off another song from her collection, but ends up revealing a picture of herself with Andy's poster. Despite her awkwardness, Andy finds it amusing and isn't upset with her. He asks if they can take a photo together, which makes Zhen Xin extremely happy. She can't stop smiling as they pose for the picture, feeling incredibly lucky. As Andy Law is about to leave, Zhen Xin stops him and requests an autograph, even though she claimed not to be a fan. Andy is surprised but agrees and writes it to someone named Lin Truly. He asks if Zhen Xin attended his concert, and she confesses but mentions that she missed it due to sold-out tickets. However, Andy gives her a lifeline by providing a cell phone number to call for help. Zhen Xin can't believe her luck and is beaming with excitement. Later that night, Zhen Xin reached the concert venue and dialed the number Andy had given her. She introduced herself as Lin Truly, and to her surprise, Tai Yu answered the call. He greeted her with a playful reference to a silly game they used to play, leaving her momentarily speechless. Then on the big screen, Andy Law's posters appeared, and Andy himself invited them to join the concert, which was just about to begin. Andy explained that the concert was dedicated to those who truly love someone, inspired by his friend's commitment to keeping a promise to his first love. Hearing that the concert was dedicated to people who loved someone deeply, Zhen Xin was moved to tears. Overwhelmed with emotion, she turned to Tai Yu. He wondered why she hadn't entered the concert yet, given that it was starting soon. Zhen Xin sadly admitted that she didn't have a ticket. Tai Yu, Ever the creative thinker, smiled and did what he used to do in the past. He created a makeshift Andy Lau singing poster. The two friends shared a laugh as they reminisced about Taiyu's old promise. They warmly greeted each other, and Taiyu escorted Zhen Xin inside to watch Andy Lau's concert live, fulfilling his promise to her and realizing his own biggest dream in the process. The end. So the moral of the story is sometimes, all you need to do is put on some roller skates and teach your crush how to skate, and everything will work itself out.